Hey guys, it's Aubrey from MikeSharif.com. I'm going to quickly do a tutorial for you on how to create a simple ebook image. This is a really fun process, and we're going to be using a Photoshop action from PSDCovers.com. I've included the link in the description box for this video. A couple quick startup notes. You'll see that I'm using Adobe Photoshop CS6. This process should be relatively similar no matter what version you're using. Unless you're using Elements, this will not work for you if you're using Photoshop Elements. So if you want to go on over to the Adobe website and download the trial version, that would be a great idea. Anybody else who wants to do that, I've also included the link to that in the description box as well. So when you download the action, you're going to load it into your Actions tab. You're going to do that by clicking the extra menu there and hit Load Actions, and then find it in your Downloads folder or wherever you saved it and load it in. Once you've done that, it should show up at the bottom here. You'll notice I've got a few of them. These are really fun actions to use. Today we're going to be using hardcover number 2. I'm going to drop that little menu down, and we have 2 steps. You'll see they make it really easy for you. You'll see that my Photoshop covers here for my ebook really aren't that exciting. Yours are going to look a lot better. I just did this really quickly in Illustrator to give us something to play with today. So hit that first step. We're going to push play. We're going to let the action do its magic and set up a canvas for us to use. And this will be our template. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so that I can better see what I'm working with. I like to be able to see the outside of my template so that I know that I'm lining things up correctly. So you're gonna wanna grab, you can either copy and paste or you can just drag and drop. I prefer the drag and drop method. So go ahead and center that there. What you wanna do, even though it might make it look just a little stretched out, is you're going to fill up this template exactly. And it will make sure that everything is lined up correctly when the time comes. So go ahead and hit the little check mark to accept that. And it looks like I missed just a little bit. So I'm going to make that just a tiny bit bigger. Hit that check mark again. We're going to place that right there on the image. We're going to go over here and grab our spine image, drag and drop that. And of course, this isn't lined up correctly. So what I like to do is I go under Edit, hit Transform, and rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Super easy. You don't have to worry about whether or not it's exactly right on. It just does it for you. Makes life a lot easier. So go ahead and stretch this out as well. Line that up. Make sure that it's matching. Hit that button, that check mark there. And now you have it in the borders of your template. So we're going to go ahead and go to step 2. And this is where it adds the pizzazz. So hit play and watch that magic happen. It's pretty fun to watch it go through everything that would have taken you quite a long time if you did it all by yourself. Now, if you know the graphic design stuff, you can play with this if you want to, but this is a whole lot easier if you just let the program do it. And there, you're done. You have this beautiful book cover, and all you had to do is drag and drop. So now we see we've got a whole bunch of layers over here. We're going to want to flatten that. Go up to Layer, Flatten Image, and that quickly makes it into one nice, easy image. Looks pretty nice. Looks like you either hired a really expensive graphic designer or you know an awful lot about how to make things work on Photoshop. So makes you look pretty good. Go ahead and go in and save it. We're gonna save this on our desktop as cover 1. You can name this whatever you would like to. Make sure it's a JPEG. You don't want another kind of file. You can do it as a PNG or a BMP if you want to, but JPEG's just easier. So go ahead and hit save. It'll give you the option of what size you want it. You can have a small file. You can have a large file. Just for my purposes today, I'm going to do a medium file. Works well on the internet. It's just a good size. So hit OK. And there you go. You've got your cover for your ebook.